What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Steve.
I'm Lindsay.
Today we're going to be reacting to the top 10 David Attenborough moments. I know this name, but I don't really know who this person is.
Yeah, I've heard the name, but I don't know why.
I wanted to check this out because a while back I did a video and David Attenborough was mentioned in that video. And I was like, I know who that is. I know his name, but I can't place why I know him. Right. And a lot of people in the comments were surprised that I didn't really know anything about him.
So he must be very iconic.
Yeah, that's what I figured based off the comments of that video. I can't remember what video that was and what they were talking about. It was just, they said his name in passing. At that moment in the comments, I realized this must be someone more iconic to British history or British culture in general. So I thought it'd be good to go ahead and check this guy out. Obviously, he is fairly well known. I think we'll go ahead and go to his wiki page to just learn a little bit more about him. Yeah. All right, guys. So Sir David Frederick Attenborough, he's 98. Wow.
Okay. Oh, he's still alive.
Yeah, I thought
he
was
about to he did have a birthday. Just had a birthday.
Okay. So it looks like he is a biologist, a British broadcaster. That must be what Maybe I know him from some sort of like
BBC Natural History. Planet Life on Earth. Is he the one who narrates? Yeah.
The Blue Planet.
Is he the one who narrates like the really like the National Geographic type stuff?
Yeah, I bet that's how I know him.
I bet we know his voice.
Yes, that's the thing. I bet I've seen him and heard him, but I never knew his name.
Yeah.
Do you see National Geographic here? Because that's
Natural World. I think it's more BBC as well. What he does.
I don't know, guys. Has he done anything like National Geographic? Because obviously we don't really see a lot of BBC content here in the U.S., so I'm not really sure, you know, where I may have seen him up, but he actually does look kind of familiar.
He does. Yeah.
And I don't know what I may have seen him in. Maybe I have seen The Blue Planet or something like that, or one of these other programs he's been in. Looks familiar. Don't really know exactly where I may have seen him or where I may have heard of him, but considering he has done a lot of things that are sort of the type of thing you would see on National Geographic, which I have, you know, I've seen a number of programs from National Geographic. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe there are things from that I've seen him on or heard him or something.
More than half a century, David Attenborough has brought the wonders of nature into our front rooms. For this list, we'll be focusing on his most memorable moments from documentaries, interviews, and other public appearances. Number 10, the Capercaillie, the life of birds. This documentary series studied the evolution of birds, plus their shared and singular habits, casting new light on hundreds of species. During the course of its filming, Sir David covered over 250,000 miles, visiting more than 40 countries, yet arguably its best and most memorable moments came close to home, in the highlands of Scotland. As Attenborough enters the territory of the world's largest species of grouse, the capercaillie, he comes face to face with a bird that mistakes him for a love rival. Run, David, run!
This being the breeding season, that he will display action to almost anything, including me!
Oh my gosh!
No doubt.
Number 9, the wolf.
Okay, so basically, David Attenborough did a lot of traveling. I'm guessing he probably traveled to the Amazon and obviously to, looks like, is that the Arctic or something?
All over.
Yeah, all over. They said 250,000 miles. Was that just for that program?
I think it was just for that one.
Cool. The Life of Mammals. In his memoir, Adventures of a Young Naturalist, Attenborough tells the story of how he once wrestled a red-maned wolf in Argentina. Perhaps that is how he got to know the animal so intimately, for in the following clip, he shows off an impressive ability to copy their call.
Wow.
Is that him?
As the presenter explains how wolves are able to communicate across long distances, his impersonation is so convincing that he appears to draw responses from an entire valley full of the animals.
Oh my gosh.
It's eerie and incredible at the same time.
Oh, that's wild, man.
Number 8, meeting Barack Obama. David Attenborough meets President Obama. On the occasion of Attenborough's 89th birthday, he was invited to the White House by the then President of the United States.
Sir David Attenborough, thank you so much for being here. As I was telling you in our walkover, I have been a huge admirer of your work for a very long time.
Obama wanted advice about the most critical issues threatening the Earth in the 21st century, and after half a century as a leading naturalist, no one is better placed to give it than Attenborough.
And the rising in temperature, global temperature, is a very, very serious worry indeed.
Of course, he has long been a spokesman on issues such as climate change and conservation, giving this sobering warning in his 2000 documentary series, State of the Planet.
But it's now increasingly apparent that one species, our own, has developed the unique ability of so altering its surroundings that it can destroy whole species, indeed, whole environments.
Number 7, Lonesome George, Galapagos 3D. The Pinta Island tortoise, Lonesome George, was once the last known member of his species and the rarest creature in the world.
Wow.
This is the rarest living animal in all the world.
When Attenborough visited the Galapagos National Park in 2013, he was granted just 30 minutes alone with Lonesome George. He was asleep for most of it, but awake for a few crucial moments.
So, wow. How old is that tortoise?
I don't remember. Did it say?
I didn't hear that. Wow. Wait. Are they saying that's literally the only one left of that species of tortoise or that?
I don't know.
What?
It's the
now
rarest.
George lives in his own enclosure, completely safe, but entirely by himself.
Mm. Sadly, George died a fortnight after this clip was filmed, but has since become an important symbol for conservation efforts in the Galapagos Islands and beyond.
He's not the only one.
And George and David briefly became one of television's greatest double acts.
But at least he can be a living inspiration for us all to protect the remainder of the reptiles and amphibians of the world.
Number 6, Birdsong Bloopers, Attenborough's Paradise Birds. Attenborough achieved a childhood ambition when he travelled to New Guinea to film Birds of Paradise for Attenborough in Paradise in 1996. And he has continued his association with some of the world's rarest bird life ever since,
what?
Including
Whoa.
Narrating
what is that?
These images.
That's beautiful.
What is that? Is that the back of it?
Bird. I think it's the front.
That's the front?
I think. It like puffs up to make itself look.
That's cool. That's one of the coolest birds I've ever seen.
It's really pretty.
It's almost like it looks like it would glow in the dark or something.
Mm-hmm. ...of the creature's courting rituals, which are regarded as some of the greatest wildlife footage ever captured. But not everything always goes according to plan.
This surely is one...
As a consummate professional, Attenborough usually records his scripts in a small number of takes, yet here one bird was determined to upstage him.
By about the 18th century. And so... Very well.
Number 5, the Adele voiceover. The Greg James Show.
Look as the world's most famous pop star zooms down a dirt track in an old Mini.
During his distinguished career, Sir David has provided plenty of hilarious voiceovers on subjects ranging from nightclubs to Olympic curling. But perhaps his most famous alternative voice work came in 2015, when Radio 1 DJ Greg James challenged him to narrate the opening to Adele's music video for her song Hello.
Her surroundings are unfamiliar and unwelcoming, but this is no match for such a cool customer, so she decides to tidy up a bit. Oh, dusty, isn't it?
With a script in the style of one of his famous documentaries, this performance underlines not just Attenborough's versatility, but also his sublime sense of humour.
The lesser-spotted Adele is about to be everywhere again. Hello.
Number 4, the orangutan.
Oh, did that make it onto the actual...
No, it was just
okay.
Like a radio.
Yeah, I thought so. I didn't know if she actually
no,
used
was,
that.
At first, I thought
that would be hilarious
saying, but...
if she used that. The orangutan. Zeus Quest. Oh, that's... Wow. 50. When did he get started? I didn't even see that.
I didn't either.
He's 98.
A while.
So, I mean, he was born in what... Was he born in 29? I think that's what it said. No, it could be 29. It'd have to be early next, because it'd be 100, I guess.
I think it's 26, 19.
Yeah, because he'd be 100 and 2026, yeah. So.
10. Zoo Quest. Heading back to Attenborough's first major TV appearance, here he partners with staff from London Zoo to collect specimens for their expanding collection, an accepted practice back then.
And soon, every time I passed his cage, he stretched out his hand to attract my attention in the hope that he'd get some more food.
Is that his voice?
I think so.
Isn't that wild? It reminds me like how someone's voice changes over time.
Yeah, it's not just our bodies. Our
voices. No, our voices definitely change. Yeah. It makes me wonder. I wish I could go back and see, like, in the last, say, 15 years, how my voice changed.
I mean, probably not a ton.
But it probably will when I look back 20 years from now.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I'm trying to think about you. How's your voice changed? I can't picture it, though, really. I can't picture how it's changed, but that's wild. You hear the difference there? There's so much more bass in his current voice than there was when he was that, you know, 20s.
And this now famous clip shows Attenborough's natural affinity with the animals as he wins the trust of the orangutan, Charlie, and eventually coaxes him out of his cage and onto deck. Once rehomed in England, Charlie actually fathered the first orangutan to be born at London Zoo, establishing its breeding colony.
Within a few days, he was so tame that he allowed me to put ointment on the bad grays which he had on his wrist.
Sophia, number three, the blue whale. The life of mammals.
The blue whale.
Meeting a blue whale was another of Attenborough's boyhood dreams, and another he fulfilled when he helped to capture this stunning footage of the mighty marine mammal. Attenborough's obvious excitement threatens to spill over as the creature surfaces mere meters from his boat, yet he retains his professionalism just enough to faultlessly deliver a perfect piece to camera.
Only in the sea can you get such huge size as that.
Wow.
A clear fan favorite moment from the presenter's long and distinguished back catalogue. Few scenes so magnificently sum up the magic.
Look at that.
Yeah.
I would love.
Can you imagine how breathtaking it would be, especially to be on such a small raft or boat, like have a huge whale like that.
Yeah, that'd be crazy. I would love to have that experience.
Be a little terrifying too.
A little bit, yeah, a little bit. They could take you out at any moment easily.
Of the natural world,
and as it tilts its 100-ton body downwards, so it can plunge to the black world 500 feet or more below the surface.
Number two, the baby rhino, Africa. This documentary, obviously set exclusively in Africa, features one of the most moving moments of Attenborough's entire career as he befriends a blind baby rhino called Nikki. In an interview for Radio 5 Live, Sir David admitted to sometimes crying over the suffering of the animals that he encounters, but he maintains that it's inappropriate for presenters to intervene or even show their emotion. Those principles were surely pushed to their limits here. Nikki never did get his eye operation, but still thrived in the care of a Kenyan wildlife team.
Oh, that's sad.
Number one, mountain gorillas. Life on Earth. This clip has been regularly voted not just as a standout David Attenborough moment, but as one of the top TV moments in general of all time. Filmed in Rwanda, it begins with a scripted section about the largest members of the ape family. But after feeling the hand of a female gorilla on his head, Attenborough's encounter with the group gets a little closer than he'd anticipated.
I can't believe they let him get that close.
Yeah, I know.
That's scary.
That's pretty close. Yikes.
Yeah. He did.
Sometimes they even allow others to join in.
And the reason why the presenter is smiling and grimacing throughout? Because out of shot, two playful baby gorillas are carefully removing his shoes.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
That takes guts.
I don't know for sure, but I think this might be something I've seen from him like a long time ago. That looks so familiar for me. Or it might be the Blue Planet or something. I don't know. I believe I've seen something with him.
I definitely recognize his voice.
Yes, me too.
And I've seen something he's done.
And he does look familiar.
What a legacy.
Yeah. Yeah,
all the awards he's won, everything he's achieved.
Like, obviously, just seeing this, it just goes to show that why it seems like he is very iconic and very well known, especially in the UK, probably world over, especially if you're really into like the study of animals and things like that. I just can't even imagine like going into some of these situations, like being there rolling around with like the gorillas.
The normal everyday experience.
Right? Really, like
Jasper and Dolly.
Yeah. Oh, man.
The monkeys.
Oh, goodness. Oh, man.
They loved you.
Yeah, monkeys loved me. I'll just put it like that. They love to crawl on my head. I didn't have cable growing up. I literally had the rabbit ears that would pick up the local channels. And so seeing things like this would have been something maybe I would have saw in school or something like that. Because obviously we didn't have, you know, internet and whatnot. So, you know, if I didn't have cable, it's very unlikely you're going to see things like this on TV. So outside of PBS.
Yeah.
But what'd you think?
Awesome. Yeah. He's done a lot. He's studied a lot of animals, the planet. I mean, it's just his contribution to the world has been vast, it seems like.
I wonder if him and, oh, what's that woman?
Jane Goodall.
Jane Goodall.
That's what I think of when I see the girls.
Yeah, yeah. Let us know in the comments if they've done something together. Let us know what we should check out next in regards to this type of content.
Yeah.
You know, I haven't really checked out a lot of the you know, animals and things like that in the UK. That's something I'm very interested in checking out. I'm going to do something about like with that soon. Check out some of the like rare animals that you'll find only in the UK and nowhere else. Enough rambling from us. Thank you so much for stopping by. Please click that like button. Feel free to drop your comments or suggestions about this video or others. And don't forget to subscribe to continue to follow us on our journey to learn about anything and everything from the UK and Ireland. Till next time, guys. Peace.
Bye.